Hi, and welcome to the Teaching Corner. Today we're going to talk about using touch points for division. So we've done addition, subtraction, and multiplication, and now our last one is division. So if you'll notice, I've written a little box above here. Just like with multiplication, our students are going to use skip counting to help them get to the answer. So they're going to count by twos until they get to six. And in this little box, they're going to tally how many times they did that. So they're going to say 2, 4, 6. And then they're going to say, I got to the number. How many tally marks do I have? 3. So 6 divided by 2 is 3. Then they'll do it again. They'll say, how many times do I count by 5 to get to 35? 5, 10, 15, 20, 25, 30, 35. I did it 7 times. Of course, in order for your students to do this, you're going to have had to do some tally work ahead of time so they know that every time you get to, you do 4, the next one is a slash mark, and you group tallies by 5 to make it easier to count. Then they're going to say, how many times will 9 go into 81? Now, they could, if they know the number trick on their hands, they could make 81 on their hands. And they could say, okay, I need 1, so I'm going to put that down. Does that leave 8 on this side? Yes, it does. So what finger is that? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. So 9 times 9 is 81. Or if they needed to, they could count by nines and tally it the other way. In a larger number, we're going to say, does 5 go into 4? No, it doesn't. So we're going to have multiple steps on this one. So what I like to do now is teach kids the division buttons. And division buttons, on the side of their paper, we're going to write divide, multiply, subtract, bring down. So if it doesn't just easily go into the number and we're going to have more things happening with it, I have them write these division buttons. And another way they can do this with their hands is divide, because you divide across the top, multiply, because you use that side number to multiply, subtract, because you're subtracting under here, and bring down. Divide, multiply, subtract, bring down. Divide, multiply, subtract, bring down. So we're going to put our finger here and we're going to say divide. So 5, will it go into 4? No. So we're still on divide. Will 5 go into 46? Yes. So we're going to count how many times? 5, 10, 15, 20, 25, 30, 35, 40, 45. And I'm going to look at my tally marks and I'm going to say that was 9 tally marks. So since it wouldn't go into the 4 and it went into 46, it goes above the 6. So 9 times 5 was 45. So we divided, then we multiplied. 9 times 5 is 45. Now we subtract. Here's our subtraction button. 6 minus 5, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. That we don't have to do because 4 minus 4 is 0, and I tell my kids you don't have to write the 0. Then we're on this one, bring down. So we brought down, and I sometimes will have my kids write an arrow to show them to bring it down. So now we're going to say 5 goes into 10, so I need another tally box. And I'm going to count by 5s until I get to 10. 5, 10. So 5 goes into 10, I divided it 2 times, so I write my 2, 5 times, we're on multiply, 5 times 2 is 10, we're going to subtract, which is 0, and I have nothing left to bring down and no remainder, so that's my answer, 92. Now, I'm trying to turn around and not block your vision. Most of the time, if my students were doing this, they would keep this hand on whatever step that they were on. But I'm trying not to block your vision. So now we do the same thing with this one. We say 4 into 9, so we're going to do our tallies. 4, 8. So 2 times, we multiply. 2 times 4 is 8. We subtract. 9 minus 8 is 1. and we bring down. Now we do another tally box. Of course, if I had a pencil and an eraser or a whiteboard, I would just erase instead of continuing to write on the paper, but I don't have that. So we're going to say 4, 8, 12. That's 3 times. Multiply. 3 times 4 is 12. We subtract. And we bring down. Then we're going to say 4, 8, 12. And the next number would be 16, which is too high. So we're going to say 3. 3 times 4. We write 12. We subtract. And we get a remainder 2. Or if you were doing fractions, it would be 2/4, which would reduce to 1/2, depending on the age of your students and what they're working on. So that's how you use touch points to help with division. I hope this video was helpful. If it was, please like and share, subscribe, and I'll see you later. Bye!